I was at home and I get this call from Ring.
We just received a fire alarm, all okay?
My fire alarm in our cottage was going off. And then it hit me. My parents are at the cottage. The fire had started in the chimney and spread to the roof. Ring Alarm Professional Monitoring dispatched the fire department before we even could dial 911. My name is Kevin, and Ring Alarm helped save our family cottage.
Protect your home today with Ring Alarm. Go to ring.com/odyssey. That's ring.com/odyssey.
Get your live music fix with the best of Pearl Jam tribute music.
Washed in Black
will be performing for one night only, 7 p.m. on August 27th at the Federal Way Performing Arts Center. Experience a tribute to one of the most prolific bands of our time with Seattle's own Washed in Black
as they celebrate the 30-year anniversary of the release of 10.
Get tickets at fwpaec.org.
Thank you to our sponsor, Becker Retirement Group.
What's up? It's your boy, the Ted Smith. Thanks for listening to the Men's Room Daily Podcast. Want more? Check out the greatest podcast in all the land, The Podcast. Be sure to subscribe and listen to a brand new episode every Tuesday night.
Somebody out there deserves to be recognized. And the Men's Room knows just who it is. So to you, we say, bottoms up, sailor. You're the toast of our shot of the day.
Drink time it is, and as usual, we head to the drink desk and Steve a Thrill Hill to find out who we're toasting.
Yes, indeed. And today we toast 18-year-old Jacob Wise of Tulsa, Oklahoma. Now, Jacob decided that he needed new pants and new shorts, so like anyone, he just went to the local store to shop, Lyft. Jacob had no intention of actually buying anything. The plan was to steal the stuff, but as we all know, retailers are completely prepared for that. That's why they put those ink-squirting security tags on the clothing, right?
Oh, they squirt ink.
Some of them do.
Okay.
Some of them don't. My thing is, I don't know how to identify which ones do and don't. Side note, my brother, about 3 years ago for Christmas, he sent me this awesome Ravens hoodie, right? I mean, just the material's nice. Everything about it's fantastic. Heavy-ass logo, all the stuff, but that clip is on it. Right, so I don't know if you ordered it online and or whatever, or he stole it. Who knows? But it shows up, and I'm like, man, I want to wear this. But one, if I wear it, people are going to think I stole it. Two, if I try to take this thing off, I get a feeling going to be more trouble than it's worth. Mm-hmm. So it's still in my closet because one day I'll figure out how to get this goddamn thing off. But anyway, so I still got it. So
it's a pain. I had something like that, and you basically just had to walk into a certain store with the alarm going off. Be like, I it's okay.
Right.
I just need this tag.
I'm bringing this in.
My problem is I don't know where he got it, so I don't want to walk into any store.
And a lot of those are different. Some like drop down like a top that you would spin. Some are
right.
Others and that I have like a little clip that pops it in on both sides. And yeah.
Either way, I'm at a loss. And they use whatever tool they use to remove it. But Jacob, I cannot explain how. I assume he probably worked in retail at some point. He was able to remove the tags. No ink blew up, nothing like that. But here's the thing. All he had to do now was just walk out of the door. Unfortunately, when he went through the door, the alarms went off anyway. And do you know why? Because Jacob Wise, well, he doesn't live up to his last name, but while he successfully removed the tags, he put the tags in the pockets of the clothes that he was stealing, walked out, right, activated the security, and they busted him. He was arrested for shoplifting. So let's drink. I know, man. Like, really, dude, again, I'm not encouraging you to be a thief, but if you're going to be a thief, can you not reflect so poorly on the human race? That's all. So we pour this booze and we drink this booze because we think it's yummy.
Yummy!
So over the tongue and down the throat to pate in our tummies.
Down the hola, bitchola!
The Men's Room presents Profile This.
And Stephen Throw Hill, can you please tell everyone how Profile This is played?
I sure can, Miles. It's a simple game where we share with you a real-life news story. Something that happened right here on planet Earth. And as you listen to the story, based on the stereotypes you believe to be true of people and the decisions that people make, we'll ask you what it is you think makes a story a story. Hello, Sean. Welcome to the Men's Room.
Hola.
Hola. Sean, by the way, I just got news here for multiple people that if I just put a high-powered magnet over the point of plastic and point it at the plastic piece, it will come apart. This is being said by multiple people. It's just a
Do
magnet.
Do you have a high-powered magnet? Does anybody you know own a high-powered magnet?
I know my father does. I know
okay,
he does.
All right, there you go.
Because he's that guy. All right.
Game over.
All right, Dad, I'll be seeing you soon. All right there, Sean, you understand how this here game is played?
I do.
Fantastic. As always, you get one of three stories to choose from. The wonderful world of drugs? Bite me. In other words, what did someone find in their food? Or interior decorating, where you guessed the foreign object that ended up inside of someone?
Let's go with drugs.
Let's go with the wonderful world of drugs. Here is your story. Well, we go back to Tulsa, Oklahoma, where first responders there spent 3 hours trying to get an intoxicated man off the top of an ambulance. They said the man was high and had just been released from the hospital. Crews said the man was energetic and thought people were trying to kill him. Instead of forcing him down, they decided to let the drugs wear off in order to keep everyone safe. Cell phone video shows the man pacing back and forth on top of the ambulance at a gas station. Tulsa police say that the EMS had taken the man to the hospital earlier in the day because he was high. They said he was released, walked to a gas station, climbed on top of the ambulance where the EMS workers were there getting gas. Crews say the man was agitated, sweating, convinced someone was trying to kill him. Quote, he was saying the mafia was out to kill him most of the night. We reassured him that that's why we were there, up close to him, so no one could shoot him. You know, they'd have to shoot us too. And we tried to calm his fears down until we got him convinced that no one was going to kill him. Authorities went on to say that nobody on the scene wanted to make matters worse, so they just stayed calm and listened to him for hours. He says they surrounded him to keep him from falling, and then they just talked to him. They were finally able to get him down safely and take him back to the hospital. Police say the only crimes he could be accused of are public intoxication and possible malicious mischief. That's for walking on top of the ambulance. So they knew he was high. They knew what he was high on. The EMS guys are like, we just dealt with this clown a little while ago. Question is, what drug was he on? Was he on PCP, methamphetamine, acid, or bath salts? PCP, meth, acid, or bath salts?
All right. Sounds like PCP, but I'm going to go, what's Ted think?
Where was he at again?
This is Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Yes.
Right, so they stopped him once. Or the EMTs dealt with him once.
The history that we know from the story is, yeah, they dealt with him once, took him to the hospital. He was released after a few hours and basically wandered out of the hospital across the street to the gas station and then spent 3 hours on top of the ambulance. Not threatening people, but he was convinced that there was a threat to him. So that's one reason the cops were kind of patient. Like, he's not threatening anybody. He's just, he's whacked out and very paranoid.
PCP, I have a hard time of thinking they'd let you leave the hospital. I feel like you'd freak out or do something crazy. I've heard stories of people being on acid and having a run-in with an ambulance or whatever, and things seem to go fine. Cause,
right.
You know what I mean? Like the fire department, like they're not cops. They're not going to arrest you. They just need to know what you're on so they can help you.
Yeah, and they were like, you're not doing.
Please remember that, people.
I wonder if he was still on the same drug that he was admitted for earlier in the day, or he re-upped.
I don't know if he re-upped.
Because he was fine enough to be released from the hospital. So my money says he must have re-upped on the way out.
That is my guess, just based on the right. He went to the hospital because he was high on this drug, and then they released him, which would lead me to believe he was coming down.
Here's my theory on this. Bath salts take a while, from what I understand, as far as being the length of a buzz. So does acid. Acid's typically between 6 and 8 hours to take a whole hit. PCP tends to stick around for a long time, some cases 18 hours. I don't know too much about meth. I know you can go on a meth bender for a long time.
Sure.
But if they're waiting for the drugs to wear off, it seems to me the logical choice in this and his ability to get it so quickly after getting out of the hospital would lead me to guess that it's methamphetamines.
See, I think he took some acid, takes a while. So he went into the hospital, then he got out, but he didn't realize how much it was still affected him. Plus, I feel like I've seen people on acid before kind of talk normal and then be like, hey, I'm on acid.
Well, they also said they were waiting for him to come down. So either way, yeah. I mean, they obviously knew he wasn't going to last very long on whatever he was on.
Well, come down so physically
they,
from
so,
the...
Yeah, so they knew the drug.
No, but let the drug wear off enough.
Before they go up to get him.
He wasn't not high when he got off the ambulance, but he was done with his paranoid episode. They just wanted to get him to that part. Yeah. So, like, he'll be combative if he's convinced everyone's out to kill him, and then we grab him. So
I just don't think he had time. It seemed like he walked across the street, and bam, he's back in it. I'm going with acid.
You're going with acid?
Yo, LSD.
Sean, what are you thinking?
Yeah, let's go acid.
There you go.
You and Ted are doing acid.
What are you saying there, Moss?
I'm going to go meth. We're going to find out if this guy was on PCP, meth, acid, or bath salts next.
That was a tease. So I just left the house to go pick up my kids. And 10 minutes later, I got a motion alert from Ring. My alarm was going off.
I open up my app, and there's this guy running out the front door.
I didn't know who he was. Before I could do anything, I got a call from Ring.
This is Jordan with Ring Alarm Monitoring. I'll send the police right over.
My name's Nadine, and Ring helped save my house from a break-in.
Protect your home today with Ring Alarm. Go to ring.com/safety. That's ring.com/safety.
There's a lot of streaming services out there, each filled with reality TV, comedy, drama, and of course, superheroes. But there's one dedicated entirely to nonfiction TV and documentary films, and that's Curiosity Stream. History, science, nature, we've got it. Space, dinosaurs, big cats, we've got that too. And pretty much anything else you want to explore. Go ahead, add some smart TV to your smart TV with Curiosity Stream. Go to curiositystream.com to sign up and start streaming today.
The Men's Room returns with Miles and Thrill, 99.9 KISW.
We head to Oklahoma on Profile This. Today, what was the drug? First responders spent 3 hours trying to get a man off top of an ambulance. Actually, they were just waiting for him to let the drugs wear off. He had been hospitalized earlier because of drugs. They knew the drugs he was on, so at that point in time, they're like, let him do his thing as long as he doesn't hurt the ambulance, I guess, and then we'll get him off there. Question is, what drug was he on? Was it PCP, meth, acid, or bath salts?
And that is the very question that we posed to you, Sean, and you did what a lot of people do. You said, Ted, what do you think? Ted knew it out, and he came up with acid, and you agreed.
Acid.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh. I'm sorry.
Oh.
The Miles, you had basically the best explanation. Consider where you are, what's easy to get your hands on, and all that.
Oh!
Sorry. Now, our friend in Tulsa, Oklahoma, that spent 3 hours on top of the ambulance on bath salts. Bath salts.
Bath salts.
Or bath sauce. Or something.
Mm-hmm. He probably could run to the convenience store and buy more of that, I guess. Now, for all TV news all the time, it's time for TV Time of 10.
And now, because your pathetic life is confined to countless hours in front of a talking box, the Men's Room presents TV Time with Ted.
Anybody watch the baseball this weekend?
Yeah.
On and off, yeah.
Yeah, it was kind of crazy. Like, it's back. There's no people in the stands. I am pro cardboard cutout.
I've seen a lot of teams not have it. It looks weird.
Yeah, I think it looks more awkward without people in the stand. I mean, look, I know there's none of them are real people, but I really like it when they have the cutouts, man. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so where Migs got his daughter cardboard cutout for when the Mariners play at home.
It's kind of
exciting to see your kid on TV.
Sure.
You know what I mean?
And I want to say, if the foul ball hits you, they make a donation.
Or you get to keep the foul ball, let's hope.
Or you get the foul ball, my bad.
Yeah. Okay.
That makes more sense.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
If it hits you. I like it.
Well, right, cardboard.
It could take your head off on a cardboard cutout, theoretically.
Yeah.
I mean, a screecher down the line. And I know they haven't improved those nets now because they don't have to.
But it's also kind of funny. That was such a big deal about people getting hurt. It's like, well, there's nobody there. You actually don't need the nets now.
Yeah,
you don't
care. No worries.
Have you seen the pictures of all the mascots?
No.
So, like, the mascots were still there, right? I mean, it's sports, right?
It is sports, sure.
You got to have mascots. But, like, again, if you've watched some of the Korean League, like, they have, like, a couple cheerleaders in there as well. So the mascot has somebody to interact with. These are just lonely mascots.
Uh-huh.
Right? So they're just like, it's cool they're back in the stadium, but they're the only ones in there. I saw, the Philly Fanatic was messing with like a cardboard cutout of a fan of another team or whatever. But BuzzFeed had a pretty funny list. It's just like, look at these mascots. Just kind of.
Just chilling.
Just kind of hanging out, trying to not be awkward.
Trying to fire up the crowd, the cardboard crowd.
I mean, at least you're getting paid.
great. You got the best seats in the house.
How hot do you, I mean, think about it. I'm a mascot. I am in this uniform. It's 100 degrees outside, and there's no one to entertain. Like, this sucks.
It's still pretty funny, though.
It is.
It does look lonely.
It does, because no matter what, they still have a smile on their face. That's the best part.
Right, and I think having the mascots there or having the cardboard cutouts or even just having the game on kind of just reminds people of a semblance of what you used to do.
Oh, sure.
You know what I mean? Like, I was with a buddy. We were outside when we were watching the game, eating a chicken wing, and I was like, this just feels kind of normal. Like, there's a live sporting event on. It's a Mariners game.
Well, they piped in the noise, right?
They got blown out, but...
But once you get used to the piped in noise, you don't think about it anymore, right? Because these guys are like master DJs with their crowd noise, you know? If there's a hit, man, the crowd... anything. And I'm like, kind of forget no one's there, because you're right, even... It's just these two-dimensional things in the stands, the crowd noise. It's all artificial, but it does it does kind of help you engage in the game.
And that's one weird thing about watching the NBA preseason too, because you're typically from a TV standpoint, you know, the cameras are up top on the like on the medium level, mm-hmm. they shoot down, and it's almost like you're watching somebody's dad who's filming his son's high school basketball game. Like, he's over in the corner, you know what I mean? He's, like, five rows up. You got this weird angle coming in. It almost looks like high school. Actually, high school basketball that I've watched on television that ESPN does, much better camera angles than what even we're seeing from the NBA.
Well, the NBA's – so here's the deal. The NBA and the MLS, right, they're all in Orlando,
mm-hmm.
And they're in a bubble. So the NBA, to me, almost looks odder because they're playing in these smaller arenas and gyms, but it's – it almost looks like the wide world of sports hosts a bunch of AAU tournaments.
Yeah, yeah.
Whereas baseball, they're not in a bubble, so it looks kind of normal because they're in the stadiums. But also, you know, the Miami Marlins had to cancel their game today. So a bunch of people got sick.
12.
Or a bunch of people tested positive, I should say. 12. Right. So you're right. NBA does look kind of crazy down there the way they're playing. Also, the NBA guys, like, listen. They've been down there a couple weeks already. This season is going. I think those games are going to get kind of intense.
I think they will too, man.
Because they're going to be horny.
They're horny. They don't, you know, a lot of them have kids and stuff. You haven't seen your kids or nothing.
But it's the nature of competition, mm-hmm. and you're in a bad mood.
Correct.
You know, it's like having a headache all day and, I don't know, getting pulled over by a cop. Like, I don't want the ticket, but you're not going
to
be gracious.
And the NBA lifestyle does not lend itself for you to not, you know, I mean, you're a multi-millionaire to play in the NBA. Your life is much different than anyone else's.
Right.
So to be quarantined like
even
that.
Even in sports, I think the NBA is a little different than most.
In general, you know?
Yeah, and and the other thing, too, is, like, you just get bored. Like, I love Disney World. I have no desire to spend 3 months there.
No.
Right.
No, and not be able to go anywhere.
Yeah.
I mean, you're sitting in the world, but you can't go ride the rides.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the point?
All right, let's see. Some sad news here. Regis Philbin passed away. Regis, he was 88, by the way. You would know him, obviously, for Regis and Kathy Lee. They hosted live. Right, and then Kelly Ripa hosted with them. So Regis, you know a lot of things about him. He was kind of known for being crazy. I know he was a massive Notre Dame football fan.
Yes.
Listen to that. So this is just some clips of, remember, he was the first original host of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. He hosted the first season of America's Got Talent. So this is just kind of a mashup. You'll hear a bunch of them, some of him on the Live with Regis and Kathy Lee, some of Live with Regis and Kelly.
I would not like you to meet Regis Philbin.
Coming up next on the premiere edition of Live with Regis and Kathy Lee.
Here are Regis Philbin and Kelly Ripa.
One, two, three. I'm out of control.
And then the third daughter broke her leg. I mean, it never ends in your place.
What?
No.
Just what the hell is that?
Daughter Grace just got her big break. Well, I was close.
Welcome to America's Got Talent.
Which of these U.S. presidents appeared on the television series Laugh-In?
Richard Nixon, that's my final answer.
He's won $1 million.
I have no regrets. I received an opportunity to do something that I always wanted to do.
Thank you very much for these great years together. God bless you all, and I hope I see you again real soon. Thanks, everybody.
I mean, it's sad, but also it's reach. I don't know why. Generally, when you like go through these death announcements, you know what I mean? It's kind of sad. But I was actually smiling. Like, Regis seems like the kind of person lived a full life. Everybody liked him.
Mm-hmm. Everybody liked him. I would agree. You know, he's one of the original, like, TV guys. You know, with YouTube now, all the cable channels, there's like a million different hosts that do a million different things. He came from the school of, like, look, there's three networks, and that is it. But he was one of the absolute mainstays. So even when all this new stuff started happening, he still carried some clout.
He was like the Steve Harvey of then. Like, he did, like, three shows at once, seemed like. It just seems like he was everywhere, you know? He was on Letterman constantly.
Oh, funny you should mention that. He was a frequent guest on Letterman. And here's Letterman talking about why he liked Regis so much.
The bigger they are, as in your case, the easier it is to make fun of, because I couldn't put a wrinkle in your suit. I couldn't. Regis Philbin, myself... Jay Leno, Pat Sajak, does he have a show?
No.
All of this put together could not carry your toupee.
Oh.
Could not carry your toupee.
Right, and Miles, you're absolutely right. When he would go on Letterman all the time, Regis was oftentimes kind of the butt of the joke.
Yeah, sure.
But right, obviously he really liked the dude, and they were super tight, and he loved having him on.
And Regis was one of those guys who would go out to dinner every night with somebody at a restaurant in New York City or wherever he was in L.A. And, like, you know, and he just kind of brought his just personal life home a lot of the times in the show. Like, if it was Kelly or Kathy Lee Gifford or whatever. Like, last night I was in Little Italy. And
right.
Went to this place and, you know, has a story to tell. It's kind of like a Larry David type story where nothing would go right or something went wrong. Or, you know.
He was also one of those people, like, I mean, granted, I was a kid, but that was one of the things, right? Like, if you saw that show, like, you were probably home sick or whatever. Like,
sure.
You know what I mean? Because
yeah.
I want to say it came on at, like, 10 a.m.
Yeah.
Right? So it's a time you should, as a, well, most people aren't home at then.
Right.
So it was kind of always like, oh, I'm watching live with Regis and Kelly. But Regis was just one of those people, you kind of felt like you knew him, and then if you met him, he'd be cool.
Yep.
And it said he was almost no different in person than he was on TV. So if you didn't like him on TV, you also wouldn't like him in person.
You get the idea that no one did not like Regis in
New York. Yeah, that was the sense
you get.
Yeah, I mean, outside of being a Notre Dame football fan. It's
yeah, like, I mean, we would let that go, though.
Yeah.
Barely.
Well, I mean, like, you know, like if Larry King called to get a table, he'd probably be like, oh, Larry, it's a little bit busy. But Regis, like, Regis, you got it. Come on down.
Sure.
Bring your people.
Yeah. You know, we used to run into Larry King a decent amount in the D.C. area because he used to do a show from D.C.
Mm-hmm. The Lizard and Suspenders.
Yeah. And Ted Koppel.
Yeah. I remember once I saw Ted Koppel eating soup, and it was just, my mind was just blown.
Wow.
Right? Because Ted Koppel also was doing, this is when, you know, there weren't news networks.
Right.
So whoever did.
The evening news.
The evening news for the entire country was a big, you know, Ted Koppel, Dan Rather, Peter Jennings.
I've told this before, but my father, he grew up in Houston, but summers. He would spend in a place called Eagle Lake, Texas. And he said, man, you couldn't even insult it by saying it's in the middle of nowhere. It was nowhere. And the way he explained to Summers, he said you would his grandparents owned a farm or whatever the hell. And he's like, I'm a city boy, but you made your own butter, milk, all this kind of stuff. He's like, I hated it, but, you know, looking back, he got some good stuff. But he said you would look at this dusty-ass highway, and anytime you saw a trail of dust, you hoped it was a car coming to pick you up. But he's like, inevitably it wasn't, but at the property line, there's a little fence, and he always said, this country bumpkin. And he said, man, it's like Andy Griffith show, country bumpkin, you know, the denim pants rolled up to the calf, barefoot dude. And he said, there they do, talking like this and all this. And so they got to know each other over the summers. And he said, this guy kept saying, I want to be a news anchor, was the whole thing. As my father tells the story, he said, all I could think is, good luck, man. Because, like, with that accent, it was thick. Thick. Anyway, time goes by. Father gets married, gets on with his life. He's like, the next time I see this guy that I spend summers with, he's doing this, I believe, CBS Evening News. It's Dan Rather.
Oh.
It was Dan. And he's like, had no idea. But he said, I remember, like, our last summer together, you know, 18, whatever. Like, you're the same age, about to move on with your life. And like, I'm going to try to be a reporter. My father's like, yeah, okay.
Sounds like your parents lived like a Forrest Gump lifestyle.
Kind of,
you
man.
You know what I mean? Like, your mom's in the car with Cassius Clay. Your dad's, like, over the fence.
And she didn't like
Dan
it.
Rather. Maybe they should do their own movie about the weird
kind
of encounters of their life.
But when
man.
They rattle the stuff up, but you, man, I don't know if you say things are more normal. I think people are more approachable. But Cassius Clay had just started boxing, and he was dating my mom's best friend. So they're going to do, like, the double date or whatever. And she's like, this fool, as my mom says, pulls up in, like, this nice Cadillac convertible. And she's like, look, at this time, black people did not have the money to own this kind of car. And she's like, he's a good-looking guy. But she said he talked in real life the way you saw every interview. Oh, yeah. It's good to meet you, Ken. Hop in the back of the car. Try not to stare too much at the back of my head because it's going to turn you on. She's like, it was like this all night. Whatever. A friend dated him, and sure enough, Cassius Clay goes on to become Muhammad Ali and all. I'm just like, you guys met every damn body.
There's a 28-year-old woman named Victoria Price. She's a reporter at an NBC station in Tampa. So basically, last month, she gets an anonymous email saying, hey, just saw your news report. What concerned me was the lump on your neck. Please have your thyroid checked. It reminds me of mine, which turned out to be cancer. So she goes home, talks to her boyfriend, blah, blah, blah. They decide to go get it checked. Turns out she had cancer.
Damn.
And the viewer, like, thank goodness the viewer sent her the email that was just like, hey, whatever that lump is on your neck, like, that's not right.
Somebody 2 or 3 years ago reminds me of a story of, I can't remember the scenario exactly, but someone took a
kid?
Picture.
Yeah.
Someone took a picture.
Yeah, yeah.
Posted it up on social media, and whatever the glare was in this person's eyes,
man,
they went, hey, I know what that is. I had that. And they contacted those people. And whatever they said that was, it was, and saved the person's life. I mean,
but they didn't know that the kid had a problem.
You know what I mean?
It was like a 9-year-old kid, and a parent just took a regular picture. with the way the Flash bounced back, the red eye, when they posted the picture, like you said, this person's like, look, I don't know if you know there's something wrong with your kid or not, but you need to get this checked. You need to do it soon. And this person said it in such a way it made these parents nervous because you're taking medical advice from a stranger, right, unsolicited, right? But anyway, they take the kid to the hospital, and sure enough.
But if somebody's had something, you know what I mean? They're the ones who know. That's why they know how to pronounce it. That's, you know what I mean? So that's,
if you know how to say it.
And if it's not, you still let them know, hey, look, there's a good chance that, you know, it could be. So.
No, you're exactly right. And I mean, that happens all the time. I think the worst example of it, though, and I'm pretty sure golf is the only sport this happens in, and sometimes their viewers will call in and be like, oh, that was a penalty. That dude didn't get, like,
oh yeah,
like somebody, like if a ball, like, rolls over. Mm-hmm. There's so many little, like,
right,
rules in there, but, like, can you imagine a guy on TV costing you thousands of dollars because...
Yay.
And typically it's only the leaderboard because they're the ones on TV.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So they're not showing the other guys.
Right. The people that have money to make.
Jennifer Lopez. Do you know how she got her nickname, J-Lo?
I'm guessing the J from Jen and the L-O from Lopez?
Kind of, and I guess she talked about this on World of Dance. She said Heavy D... Heavy D was a big popular rapper back in the day.
You know how he got his name?
Heavy D?
Is Heavy D Now That We Found Love? Now that we found love, what are we gonna do?
Yeah, that's it. That's
Is that Heavy D?
D?
Okay.
Yeah. That's funny. I don't
know
any
Heavy D
lyrics.
Song I know. I was like, I'm pretty sure that's the one.
So she was talking about this on World of Dance. She said he would come to the studio when I was making my first album, and he'd always call me Jenny Lowe. She was also dating Diddy at the time. So their names were showing up in other people's music. They often referred to her as Jennifer Lowe or Jenny Lowe. And she said they were sitting in the studio talking about it. She's like, I'm going to name the album J-Lo.
And that was it?
That was it.
Like Jell-O.
Yeah.
But it works.
Yeah.
Well, it's funny. Like, everyone calls everyone here by different names. But, like, Ryan Castle, I don't think I've ever said Ryan since I've met him. It's always just Castle.
Right.
Always. He never calls me Thrill. He calls me Trill. All the time. But you specifically call him R.C.
Oh, I didn't think about that.
Think about, but I mean, that's what I'm saying. Everyone, like, some people say Ryan, some people say Castle, you say RC, right?
You're exactly right. Yeah, like that.
Yeah, when you walk in, hey, what's up, RC?
Yeah,
that's a good point. Well, I hope he's okay with it.
You'd have named him J-Lo,
which is a terrible, which is a terrible cola. Actually, I took one of those RC colas home, and it was good.
That thing's like 175 years old, man.
I know, it was fantastic.
It was like in a time capsule.
Oh man, don't you worry about it. RC stays just fine. Whatever chemicals they put in there, it's a lifeline.
So it's so emotionally quick in here. Yeah. A minute ago, you hated it. Now he loves it.
RC, no, terrible cold. I've always thought
actually,
about
I took that 800-year-old. I was scared to take it home. Like, I'm not drinking
it's
that.
It's not 800 years old. They just brought it in. It's newer RC.
Ah,
yeah. I'll drink
it. I'm with you. Like, my mom loves soda, right?
Mm-hmm.
Coca-Cola is her brand. But when I was a kid, if there was any chance, RC, that was the top
Royal
dog.
Crown.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, every bottle of RC comes with a little bit of the Queen's sweat.
Oh, yeah, Royal Crown. Yeah.
Royal Crown. Yep.
Just like Crown Royal.
Yeah.
Such a difference between Royal Crown and Crown Royal.
Huge difference.
You could put them together, though.
Crown and Crown?
Yeah.
I'll try Crown and
Give
Crown.
Give me a Crown and Crown. I'm crowning.
That's a good call, right? Because you always hear Crown and Coke with
sure.
the liquor. Let's see. Disney, they're reworking Splash Mountain. They're ditching the Song of the South, and
they just picked up on that one.
Yeah, that's a little weird because the movie has Disney like that. You can't find that movie; they got rid of it years ago.
Right, they understood that, but like, which you're playing the song.
But for some reason, right on Splash Mountain, when you go through there, they would still play the song and like
Merry Christmas.
See, when I think Song of the South, I think like Alabama. You know, like their song, Song of the South. It's not the same song.
No, no, it is not the same.
Sweet Potato Pie and all that crap. That's not the song.
You mean Alabama's?
Well, I don't know the new. I'm not sure that I know the old version. I've never seen the movie. I know the whole idea of like whatever that is, that island, but I didn't know what the
You would know it. Okay. You'd recognize it probably from the ride. And like, again, I hate saying this.
Is this the Splash Mountain thing?
Is yes.
that the ride? Okay, all right.
Yeah. So I'm saying, so when you're in there, you'd recognize and be like, oh.
I always call that the log jammer, so I don't even know. Sounds like you're crapping.
It is. anyhow, they're going to change it to a Princess and the Frog ride.
Until somebody figures out something with that.
Right. Frogs.
Because the frog turns into a prince.
If you're up late night tonight, Coach Carroll will be on with Seth Meyers.
Oh, very cool. Thank you, Ted. We appreciate it. You are listening to The Men's Room.
I was at home, and I get this call from Ring.
We just received a fire alarm. All okay?
My fire alarm in our cottage was going off, and then it hit me. My parents are at the cottage. The fire had started in the chimney and spread to the roof. Ring Alarm Professional Monitoring dispatched the fire department before we even could dial 911. My name is Kevin, and Ring Alarm helped save our family cottage.
Protect your home today with Ring Alarm. Go to ring.com/odyssey. That's ring.com/odyssey.
If 2020 has taught us anything, it's to take nothing for granted. So when you expect hot water and get cold, when you expect the shower to drain and it doesn't, when you turn the furnace on and it won't start, stop freaking and call Beacon Plumbing, Heating, and Mechanical. 1-800-FREAKIN.
The men's room returns with Miles and Thrill. Now, let's see what's happening in the real world.
All right, here we go. New York State man is busted for driving drunk at a high rate of speed. He dumped the buggy and injured the horse. Meanwhile, a girlfriend tells her boyfriend she will only have coitus if her friends can join in on the intercourse. Man at park practicing social distancing gets pepper sprayed in the face. The world's most identical twins plan on making the world a much uglier place. And Ohio County Fair is a go by asking people to stay one cow apart. It is time for your headlines.
Now, it's time to hit the head. Lines. Here's my car.
Top story, we're going to New York, where an 18-year-old man was arrested for DUI. Police got the call after the young man was drunk driving an Amish horse and buggy. Yes, he was speeding through an area too fast and actually tipped the buggy over, ejecting passengers and injuring the horse.
He had a lot of people in that buggy.
He did.
You gotta wonder what the speed limit was there. Right. I mean, if it's going too fast, like, it's a horse and buggy, man.
I'm trying to think on that. Do they actually enforce speed limits in Amish country?
They enforce speed limits on the roadway.
Sure.
So if I'm on my scooter, it's the same as somebody with a semi.
Sort of.
The driver was arrested and released on an appearance ticket. It's always been my contention on here that nobody should get a DUI for riding a horse, because the horse tends to go at least forward without running into trouble.
Yes, it tries to avoid hitting things.
Why are you speeding with a horse and buggy?
Because you can, and he's young.
I guess.
I mean, it can be a skateboard. You want to go as fast as you can. Horse and buggy, go as fast as you can. I don't know how fast I was, but still.
We're going to tip this horse. In other news, we go to Australia, where the world's most identical twins are looking to go even further. Mm. They've recently gone on to the local morning talk show and admitted that not only do the pair want to get pregnant at the exact same time, but by the same man. The trio have been in a relationship for a while now and say that there's absolutely no jealousy in the relationship and plan to go all the way to the end together.
Yeah, I mean, look, people do what they do, but I just saw the picture this morning and thought, no, thank you.
Yeah.
I'm not paying child support unless I'm getting laid.
That's a good point. That's
you know fair. What I mean? Like, I mean, I'll be a sperm donor, but we got to do the old-fashioned way.
The old fella.
You know, like,
I'm an old-fashioned kind of guy.
If I'm paying for kids, I want to get spend some time with them. At least, you know what I mean?
Sure.
Still want to do it that way.
But here's the thing. He's having sex with them. They're just freezing the eggs for later. So,
I see.
So that they can make sure they get pregnant at the same
then
time is their
get,
thing.
He needs to get out of it.
You think?
Yeah.
Quickly. Ted's in, though.
Oh, I am.
Well, they got those
Did
twin superpowers, man. They can talk to each other
pictures.
Without saying a word.
It's been a lonely COVID, hasn't it?
I don't know. You guys set him up bad. I was expecting worse.
Well, sure. I've definitely seen worse. But
that's the way I introduce anybody who's my friend when they're coming around for the first time. Just understand. You might not be able to look away. This is the ugliest person you've ever seen.
Yeah.
And then when they come in, they look at me and go, he's not that ugly. He's done that bad. Like, all right, good.
You
don't think so.
Over in Ohio, they're trying to keep things moving forward. The state has decided to go forward with their Butler County Fair with some safety restrictions put into place. They've taken all of the rides away from the fair and have reduced the number of games and concession stands by half in an attempt to keep the spread of COVID-19 down. And as many are doing in order to reduce question to just how far away 6 feet is, there was a sign that asked people to stay, quote, at least one cow apart.
Depending on where you are, that's exactly right. You got to do that.
Right.
In Baltimore, it would have been like, hey, stay about 17 rats apart.
Yeah. Gotcha. West Virginia would be a deer's link. Length, you know.
A man over in the UK.
Stay 12 crab cakes apart.
A man over in the UK wrote in with an interesting predicament. He wrote about a late evening that he had with his girlfriend and her three best friends where they all got decently altered and ended up having a bit of a love fest. But the problem is that now that's all that his lady wants. He said that she's trying to have sex. He's tried having sex just the two of them again, but it's been excuse after another as to why she's not into it, and only exercises the thought when her friends are involved.
Why do you care? It's like me saying, why do you like carrots? Doesn't matter why you like carrots. Just eat your carrots. Hey, brother, you can benefit from this.
He wants to get back that intimacy.
I know, and don't worry. He'll find someone else later. In the meantime...
Run!
I mean, just saying, you know.
I mean, I guess sometimes you just want a little solo time, one-on-one. Mm-hmm.
That's it for your headlines with that. Mike Hawk is out.
Thank you, Mike. We appreciate it. We'll see you next time. Ryan Castle is in, and we will once again sit and spin. The lovely Taryn Daly joins you next.
Yes, indeed. It is all true, but in the meantime, we be all up out this batch. So until next time, please do what you do best. And for Aletha's sake, stay beautiful.
The men's room has been taped before a live studio audience. Wardrobe and makeup provided by Mantastic Limited. This has been a presentation of the Men's Room Radio Network.
Oh, man.
A Double Flush production.
I was at home, and I get this call from Ring.
We just received a fire alarm. Is all okay?
My fire alarm in our cottage was going off, and then it hit me. My parents are at the cottage. The fire had started in the chimney and spread to the roof. Ring Alarm Professional Monitoring dispatched the fire department before we even could dial 911. My name is Kevin, and Ring Alarm helped save our family cottage.
Protect your home today with Ring Alarm. Go to ring.com/odyssey. That's ring.com/odyssey.